Now, the Bambu Lab A1 Mini has a big brother. Meet the Bambu Lab A1. We'll get a look at it right after this. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. Hello, 3D printing friends, and welcome back. Bambu Lab sent the new A1 over free of charge so we could get a look at it. We'll go over the specs and features, see some prints, and I'll share my experience with it while telling you what I like about it, what I don't like about it, and maybe where it could use some improvement. All right, let's get this video going. Hey, so remember that time Bambu Lab started and they released that fast Core XY printer, the X1 Carbon, and everybody cheered because the webpage said, "No more bed slingers." Well, I think maybe what really happened was they simply misspelled the word two. Because with the introduction of the Bambu Lab A1 Mini and now the A1, they've released two of them. So, why the bed slingers after saying no more of them? Well, it looks like Bambu Lab wants to make the cost of multicolor printing more affordable, and bed slingers and the AMS Lite are their way to make that happen. The A1 Mini on its own is only $299 US, and if you get it as a combo with the AMS Lite, it's $459. But some people think the 180x180x180mm build volume of the Mini is too small. So Bambu Lab has brought out the A1. It's exactly $100 more than the Mini at $399 alone, or $559 as a combo with the AMS Lite. Now the AMS Lite is the 4-spool automatic material system that lets you print up to 4 colors on a single print. And the A1 has a build volume exactly the same as every other non-mini printer they make, 256x256x256mm. And the build volume makes for a good segue to talk about the rest of the printer's specs and features, so here we go. The frame is constructed of steel and extruded aluminum with a plastic shell for aesthetics. The tool head has a direct drive extruder, feeding 1.75mm filament through an all-metal hot end to a 0.4mm stainless steel nozzle that can reach 300 degrees Celsius. Bambu Lab says it'll work best with PLA, PETG, TPU, and PVA, which is a water-soluble support material. They recommend not printing ABS, ASA, PC, PA, PET, or carbon or glass reinforced filaments. The hot end slash nozzle modules are available in 0.2, 0.6, and 0.8mm diameters as well. And much like revenge, swapping nozzles is a dish best served cold. And you can do it in about a minute without any tools. Unsnap the tool head faceplate, remove the silicone sock, unclip and remove the current nozzle, insert and clip in the new one, and put a sock on it and snap the faceplate back on. The tool head has a fan for the cold side of the hot end and a parts cooling blower to cool the model you're printing. It doesn't have any sort of auxiliary cooling blower to blast the model with air, but it also doesn't seem to need it. I mentioned the build volume is 256x256x256mm. The bed includes a flex plate with a double-sided textured PEI surface, and it can reach a maximum temperature of 100 degrees Celsius. All calibration and bed leveling is automatic, so there are no knobs to adjust to level the bed. Print speeds max out at about 300mm per second, and the maximum tool head speed is 500mm per second. It's got the same sensor suite as the A1 Mini, with power loss recovery, a low data rate camera, filament runout sensor, and a filament tangle sensor. The camera lets you monitor the status of a print job, and it can also record time lapses. But low data rate means the camera is slow to update, so don't expect a beautiful 60 frame per second video feed when live monitoring a print. Instead, it can be more like a slideshow seen through a funhouse mirror. For time lapses, use the smooth time lapse mode in Bambu Studio Slicer for the best results. With the AMS Lite connected to the printer, you can print up to 4 colors in a single print. Now, I've mentioned this in other Bambu Lab videos, but I'll mention it again. Using Bambu Lab filament with the AMS Lite is super convenient because of the RFID tags on the spools that identify the type and color of the material, but it's also 100% not required. You can use almost any spool of 1.75mm filament with the AMS Lite, as long as it physically fits on the unit and it's a material the printer can actually print. Some materials, like TPU, you'll need to feed as an external spool. For non-bamboo filament, you just have to tell the printer about the kind and color of the filament that you've loaded. The A1 has a nice 3.5-inch color touchscreen, which can rotate out of the way, two bamboo bus ports, one of which is used by the AMS Lite, and a microSD card for storing sliced models and time-lapse videos. It has active motor noise cancellation, and it's got Wi-Fi on board as well. The Wi-Fi lets you print over the network from the Bambu Studio Slicer software on your computer, or you can use the Bambu Handy mobile app on your phone to monitor and control the printer remotely. Like other Bambu Lab printers, it also has vibration compensation to improve print quality when printing faster. Also, like other Bambu Lab printers, it poops. So, after unpacking the printer from the box, assembly is relatively simple. The printer comes with all the tools that you need. Ordinarily, the AMS Lite will sit off to the right of the printer, which increases the overall footprint. But Bambu Lab has a set of files for a printable mount that lets you attach the AMS Lite to the top of the gantry. Yeah, I know. The idea of an extra 4+ kilograms of weight on top of the printer sounds nuts. That's almost 9 pounds. And in practice, I can tell you that with the AMS Lite mounted up there with 4 full spools, it can rock back and forth quite a bit. As scary as it looks though, I haven't really seen any difference in print quality with the AMS Lite up top. When we look at prints in a little bit, I'll show you one where I started with the AMS Lite mounted on top, and then halfway through it, I pulled it off and put it back on its base. Spoiler alert, there is a line on the print where I was monkeying with the gantry. So we have a very clear delineation and we can see the quality of on top versus next to. That said, if there is a particular model that you want to see me use as a test print for an on-off comparison, leave a comment now and let me know. Like the A1 Mini, the A1 comes with a few extras like this cool set of Bambu Lab filament swatches and a printable project kit. Now, where the Mini comes with one of 4 projects randomly chosen by Bambu, the A1 comes with one of 2, also randomly chosen. Bambu Lab says the A1 is aimed at more experienced users, so its projects are more challenging. Mine came with the hardware for the cutaway jet engine model, which consists of 4 bearings and an enormous number of screws and bolts. And there are also an enormous number of parts to print for this model, and I've got all of them printed. I haven't built the model yet, but I do have all the parts. What do you think? Should I do a live stream and we can hang out and put it together on stream? Let me know. That could be fun. I haven't done a live stream in forever. Okay, so speaking of printing a bunch of stuff, here are some of the things that I printed on the A1. First up is the pre-sliced Benchy that was already loaded in the printer's file list. This printed in 21 minutes. It's got the usual glossy on the bottom, matte on the top thing that I always see on fast Benchy prints from Bambu Lab printers. There's one little bit of ringing here at the anchor hole on this side of the Benchy. The rest of the print looks smooth. Nice even layers, no stringing, no gaps between walls, it's a good print. Next, the top mount for the AMS Lite. This prints in multiple pieces. There are 2 bottom parts that clamp onto the top of the gantry, and the top part that the AMS Lite bolts onto. The top part can swivel left or right on the base, and it's got another little part inside to keep it clicked into position left, right, or center. It's also got a threaded hole in the front, and that's for this last piece, a big set screw, to keep the thing locked in the center position. The set screw prints in a threads-up orientation, so it needs supports. You can see where the supports were touching the part. There's a little bit of gapping there. But the part of a print that touches supports never really looks pretty. The threads on it look good, and they worked perfectly in the threaded hole on the swiveling part. The latch works fine, and kept the AMS Lite secured to the top of the gantry for about 1.5 weeks before I took it off. Now, it's hard to tell with the white filament, but from what I can see, the print doesn't seem to have any issues. I have no complaints about the quality of this print. Okay, this is all the parts of that jet engine project that came with the printer. There are over 50 pieces to print. I did the housing in white, the central shaft parts in matte black, the blades in a medium blue, and the combustion chamber and other parts in a silk silver PLA. All told, this is 37 hours or more of printing. The big fan was a little over 5 hours, but it came out great. And check out the combustion chamber in that silk silver. Looks like there's a little bit of ringing around the holes here, but it's not bad. Not every silk silver print came out great. A couple have a not quite perfect surface, but they're the exception. This is going to be a fun one to put together, and let me know in the comments if you want me to stream the build. Next, Bambu Lab sent me 4 spools of filament and a HueForge generated file to print, and this is the result. It's a cloudy night with a full moon over a lake by some mountains. The filament colors used for this print were matte black, dark blue, medium blue, and white. I've seen people showing HueForge prints online, but until I printed one, I hadn't seen one in person. These are really, really cool. It's textured, like an oil painting. All these variations in tone are made by carefully layering the different filament colors. The only issue I had with it is that the middle of the top edge lifted just a little bit, but I still like it a lot. And last, this is the rocket plane model. This is the one I mentioned earlier, where I removed the AMS light from the gantry halfway through the print. This is a base mode print, so it's just the outer shell of the model. And this line right here, that's where I was messing with it. I removed the 4 screws holding the AMS light to the top mount, put the AMS light back onto its usual base, and then unsnapped the top mount from the gantry. I personally don't see a difference in print quality on either side of that dividing line. It's just a good-looking print. Apart from that line, the only issue I really see is one little spot where it looks like a brief under-extrusion, which left a little gap here. So, briefly on the topic of the AMS on top, ick. Comment and suggest a model I should print to see what effect a top-mounted AMS light has on print quality. I'll print the model twice, once with the AMS on top and once with it off to the side. And I'll either make a short video or just show the pictures in a post in the community tab here on the channel so we can see the result. Now the only thing I ask is that you not suggest a model that uses a lot of filament or one that's a huge time-consuming print. Well, now let's talk about what I like and what I don't like about the A1. I'll start with what I like. It prints fast, and with the active motor noise cancellation, it's pretty quiet. As with most printers that have quiet motion systems, the loudest things on the printer are the fans. The auto mesh bed leveling has worked perfectly for me, and for the most part, I've been very happy with the quality of the prints that I've gotten from the printer. And even though most of what I've shown today has been single color prints, the A1, in combination with the AMS light, is wonderful for printing multicolor models. That HueForge print is amazing, and I bought a license for it so I can make some of my own. And this last thing may not sound like much, but I like that the power cord is a standard detachable one, instead of the captive one that's on the A1 Mini. I like being able to remove the power cords from things if I need to. Now, here's what I don't like, along with some suggestions for improvement. As nice as multicolor printing is, it can produce a lot of waste, but there are ways to mitigate it, and I've got a video about one way to do that linked in the description. And on my printer, the Bowden tubes from the AMS light seem to droop or curl forward. In the product shots, they're all fine, upstanding citizens, so it would be cool if there was a way to keep those more upright as well, instead of them flopping forward. Now, speaking of those Bowden tubes, while they're easy to disconnect from the AMS light, they're nearly impossible to disconnect from the toolhead. And of course, the AMS light almost doubles the printer's footprint, unless you want to put the printer in Weebles mode by mounting the AMS on top. I've noticed that it's not as easy to align the flex plate with the bed as it is on Bambu Lab's Core XY printers. I think if Bambu Lab used the flex plate alignment method from the X1 and P1 series beds, it would be easier to get the flex plate on the A1's bed. The Bambu Studio Slicer can only display the microSD card contents of the X1 series printers, so if you want to get time lapses from the A1's card, you'll need to power off the printer, remove the card, and put it in a card reader on your computer to get access to them. I think it would be great if Bambu Studio could access and display the microSD card contents from the P1 and A1 series printers like it does for the X1 series. So, final thoughts. The A1 is one of two new bed slingers from Bambu Lab in 2023 after they famously said, no more bed slingers. Compared to Core XY, the i3 design is less complex and therefore less expensive to build. So it lets Bambu Lab sell ready-to-roll, four-color-capable 3D printers at a lower price point to get more people into fast, colorful 3D printing. My personal experience with the A1 has been great. Printing has been a breeze. All of the things that I printed, those 50-some-odd parts for the jet engine and all these other models, it's just been slice, send, and print. For me, it just works. But it's important to note that I've only had the printer for about 3 weeks, and while I've used it quite a bit, I can't say with absolute certainty that it'll keep working without issue. But my experience with other Bambu Lab printers makes me think it will. So that's the Bambu Lab A1. $399 US alone, $559 is a combo with the AMS Lite. I think it's a lot of printer for the money, and if you're looking at getting into multicolor 3D printing without having to mess a lot with the printer, just slice, send, and print, both the A1 and the A1 Mini are good choices. If you're interested in picking one up on Bambu Lab's site, there's a link in the description. Thanks again to Bambu Lab for sending the A1 over free of charge so I could show it to you. And big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. If you liked this episode, give it a thumbs up and maybe subscribe so you don't miss new ones. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this one, and now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool. We'll go over the specs and features, see some sprints.